At the end of this online module, you should be able to copy a single element from an array and assign it to a variable using array indexing, and copy an array from a larger array and assign it to a variable using array indexing. There is another very similar module on copying values using linear indexing. Let's consider a problem to explore while learning to copy values from arrays using array indexing. An engineer is working on the design of a treadmill and needs to better understand the speed at which users start their workout. Distance and time data have been provided for two users using a treadmill at resistance level 7. The engineer had assigned the data set in the table to a matrix, but would like to parse the matrix into a few different variables for other analyses as follows. Assign user 1's time value at 20 meters to a scalar. Assign user 1's distance column to a vector. Assign user 2's third through fifth data points to a matrix. We will use array indexing to copy the highlighted values in the matrix to separate variables. So what is array indexing? Let's look at a theoretical array. Notice how the elements are subscripted with their row and column number. Notice that the row number is first and the column number is second, just as when identifying the dimensions of a matrix. When you want to use or refer to any of the values in an array, you need to make reference to the row and column location of the values of interest. Say we have assigned our data for our population to a matrix. How would I reference the value of 16.8? I'd have to use the variable name for the array, user_data, and supply the row number 5 and the column number 2 in parentheses separated by a comma. In MATLAB, I have entered the original data in a variable named user_data. It is a good practice to copy pieces of any array to new variables if they are going to be used in other computations. This makes it easier for someone else to follow the code. I will use array indexing to create a variable for the value in yellow at the right. I want to copy user 1's time value at 20 meters, which is 9.1, to a variable called user 1 time 20m. As with all new variable assignments, my new variable name goes to the left of the equal sign. Then I use array indexing to copy the value 9.1, which is in the third row, second column, to my new variable. Notice that the user 1 time 20m variable now exists in the workspace with the value of 9.1. What happens if you reverse the order around the equal sign when creating variables? I will clear my user 1 time 20m variable and try this again, but in the other order. I will start by using array indexing for the third row, second column, then set that equal to my variable name, user 1 time 20m. This gives me an error, because when assigning values to variables, MATLAB treats the item on the right of the equal sign as the value that will be assigned to the variable on the left of the equal sign. Since user 1 time 20m does not exist, MATLAB returns the error undefined function or variable. So I will return to the original MATLAB code to assign user 1 time 20m the appropriate value. The next thing I need to do is assign the block of data from user 2 to a variable. Blocks of elements can be copied by referring to the beginning and end row and column numbers. I will create my variable with the name user2_dist_time and then add the equal sign. Then I must use the matrix name and open the parentheses. The values we want to copy have the first row 3 and the last 5, and the first column 3 and the last column 4. We can assign all of the rows as a vector 3:5 and all of the columns as a vector 3:4 separated by a comma. When I hit enter, you see I have created a new matrix with the dimensions 3x2 with the values of the orange block on the right. As an aside, when using array indexing, you can reference the rows and columns using any vector notation. Therefore, you can choose exactly which rows and columns you want to use. The last thing that needs to be done is to copy one of the distance data columns to a variable. MATLAB provides a shortcut for replacing entire rows and columns. A colon designates all the. In this case, I want to copy all the rows in column 1. So I will create a variable named user1_dist on the left of the equal sign And on the right, I will reference my original matrix user underscore data, open the parentheses, use a colon for all of the rows, then a comma, and a 1 for only column 1, and close the parentheses. When I hit enter, I have a new variable named user1 underscore dist that is a column vector with the appropriate values. To summarize this module, we can reference elements in an array by using array indexing, using the row and column numbers to identify the element. We know how to index blocks of elements in an array by specifying the first and last index of the row and the first and last index of the column. Finally, we reference entire rows or columns using the colon.